Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven, nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Mysterious Café in the Old Quarter. Chapter 1. The Traveler's Discovery. Ethan, a traveler with a penchant for the unexplored and a love for history, meandered through the winding streets of the ancient city. The Old Quarter, known for its cobblestone paths and buildings that whisper tales of yesteryear, always held a special allure for him. As twilight draped over the city, Ethan found himself drawn to a narrow alley he hadn't noticed before. Nestled between two old buildings, overshadowed by the towering structures around it, was a quaint cafe named Whispers of the Past. Its exterior, adorned with ivy and faded signs, exuded a charm that beckoned to passers-by with an unspoken invitation. Ethan, intrigued by its quaintness and the feeling of stepping back in time, pushed open the creaking wooden door and stepped inside. The cafe was like a portal to another era. The walls were lined with black and white photographs, antique clocks, and shelves laden with artifacts that seemed to have been gathered from around the globe. The soft, ambient light from the old-fashioned lanterns cast a warm glow over the wooden tables and chairs, each piece telling its own story of days long gone. As Ethan took a seat at a corner table, his eyes were drawn to a large, faded map of the city hanging on the wall, marked with curious symbols and annotations. The air was filled with the rich aroma of coffee and the faint sound of classical music playing in the background. The owner of the cafe, a man of advanced age with a kind face and eyes that sparkled with untold stories, approached Ethan. Introducing himself as Mr. Laser, he welcomed Ethan with a warmth that felt like a greeting from an old friend. Mr. Laser, noticing Ethan's interest in the artifacts, began to share tales of the cafe's past. With each story, Ethan was drawn deeper into the cafe's mystique. Mr. Laser spoke of the cafe's foundation several centuries ago, its role as a hub for artists and intellectuals, and its survival through the city's turbulent history. But what caught Ethan's attention the most was the tale of a hidden room within the cafe, sealed off and forgotten for decades, rumored to hold a significant piece of the city's history. Ethan's intrigue grew with every tale, every artifact he touched, and every photograph he scrutinized. The cafe wasn't just a relic of the past, it was a living museum, a keeper of secrets waiting to be unraveled. The following days saw Ethan returning to the cafe, each visit uncovering more layers of its history. He pored over old journals found in a dusty corner, spoke at length with Mr. Laser, and even met with some of the cafe's regulars, each a character with their own connection to the cafe's past. One evening, as Ethan examined the old city map, he noticed that the symbols matched some markings in one of the journals. This discovery set his heart racing. The symbols were not random, they were a code, a map to something hidden. Ethan realized that these clues might lead him to the mysterious sealed room and the secrets it held. His investigation took him beyond the confines of the cafe. He explored the old quarter, tracing the symbol's locations on the map, each step bringing him closer to unraveling the mystery. He visited local archives, delved into the city's history, and even sought out descendants of the people who had frequented the cafe in its early days. As Ethan pieced together the puzzle, he felt like he was part of the cafe's history, walking in the footsteps of those who had sat in the same corner, sipped the same coffee, and pondered over the same mysteries. But with every clue unraveled, Ethan sensed he was getting closer to something much larger than he had initially imagined. Late one night, while comparing notes and maps in the dim light of the cafe, Ethan and Mr. Laser discovered that the symbols on the map pointed to a mechanism hidden within the cafe itself, a mechanism that would unlock the way to the sealed room. Their excitement was palpable as they worked together, moving aside a bookshelf to reveal an ancient lock embedded in the wall. As chapter draws to a close, Ethan stands before the hidden lock, the key to the sealed room and its secrets in his hands. The air is thick with anticipation as he and Mr. Laser prepare to unlock a part of the city's history long thought lost to time. Chapter 2. Echoes of History. The unlocking of the hidden room and whispers of the past marked the beginning of a new chapter in Ethan's journey. As he and Mr. Laser stepped into the long sealed room, they were greeted by an air thick with dust and the sense of secrets long buried. The room was a treasure trove of artifacts, each with its own story etched in time. Ethan spent days cataloging and studying the contents of the room. There were old manuscripts, maps with cryptic markings, and personal belongings of individuals who seemed to play significant roles in the city's past. The more he delved into these artifacts, the more Ethan realized that the cafe was not just a silent witness to history, but an active participant. One of the most intriguing discoveries was a series of journals belonging to a woman named Layla, who lived during a tumultuous period in the city's history. Through her words, Ethan pieced together a tale of love, betrayal, and a secret society that influenced the course of events in the old quarter. Layla's connection to the cafe and her role in the society began to shed light on the cryptic symbols Ethan had been following. Mr. Laser, equally captivated by these discoveries, shared more of the cafe's history with Ethan. He revealed that whispers of the past had been a meeting place for the secret society, a group of intellectuals and visionaries who sought to guide the city's future from the shadows. The society had disbanded under mysterious circumstances, leaving behind a legacy shrouded in mystery. Determined to unravel this legacy, Ethan embarked on a quest that took him beyond the confines of the cafe and into the heart of the old quarter. He traced Layla's steps, visiting locations she had written about in her journals, a forgotten library, a hidden garden, the ruins of an old mansion. Each location provided Ethan with fragments of the society's story. He learned of their ideals and struggles, their influence on the city's politics and culture, and the eventual betrayal that led to their downfall. The society's members included scholars, artists, and even members of the city's elite, all united by a vision for a better future. But as Ethan delved deeper into this history, he began to sense that he was not alone in his quest. He noticed a figure in the shadows, a presence that seemed to be watching his every move. This mysterious figure, always just out of reach, added a layer of urgency to Ethan's investigation. Amidst his explorations, Ethan met a series of individuals who provided key insights into the society's activities. An old librarian spoke of secret meetings held in the library's basement. A gardener recalled conversations overheard in the hidden garden. A former servant of the mansion shared tales of lavish gatherings that were more than they seemed. With each revelation, the picture became clearer. The society had been on the verge of a major breakthrough, something that promised to change the city's fate. However, internal strife and external pressures had led to their untimely end, leaving their final project unfinished. Ethan returned to the cafe with a newfound understanding of its place in the city's history. He and Mr. Laser pored over the newly uncovered information, piecing together the society's final days. It became apparent that the key to their last project was hidden within the cafe, a secret waiting to be uncovered for centuries. As chapter draws to a close, Ethan stands at the brink of a major discovery. The cafe, with its layers of history and echoes of the past, holds the key to a mystery that has waited long to be solved. With the mysterious figure still lurking in the shadows, the stakes are higher than ever. Chapter 3. The Unveiling of Secrets. The revelation of the cafe's historical significance was just the beginning for Ethan. As he delved deeper into the mysteries of whispers of the past, he found himself entwined in a web of historical intrigue that extended far beyond the walls of the quaint establishment. Ethan's days were now consumed with decoding ancient manuscripts and unraveling the cryptic symbols that seemed to be the key to understanding the secret society's ultimate purpose. Each symbol led him to a different part of the old quarter, each location revealing a piece of the puzzle. One such location was the city's oldest library, where Ethan discovered a hidden room filled with rare books and documents. These texts spoke of a legendary artifact, known as the Heart of the Quarter, which was said to hold immense knowledge and power. The society had been on the verge of uncovering its location when they were disbanded. Ethan's investigation also led him to interact with various individuals who had ties to the society. Among them was an elderly artist who had been a young apprentice during the society's final days. She provided Ethan with a first-hand account of the society's activities and their aspirations for the city's future. Her tales were filled with passion and regret, painting a vivid picture of a group of visionaries ahead of their time. As Ethan pieced together these narratives, he began to understand the society's vision. They had sought to protect the old quarter from the encroaching modernization that threatened its historical essence. Their goal was to preserve the heart and soul of the quarter, which they believed was embodied in the Heart of the Quarter artifact. However, Ethan's quest was not without its dangers. The mysterious figure who had been shadowing him was becoming more bold. Encounters with this figure, who seemed to have a vested interest in stopping Ethan, grew more frequent and perilous. It was clear that there were others who were aware of the artifact's significance and were determined to find it for their own purposes. Undeterred, Ethan continued his research, each day growing more connected to the cafe and its legacy. He felt as if he was becoming a part of its history, a custodian of the secrets that it held. Another breakthrough came when Ethan discovered a series of letters between members of the society hidden within a secret compartment in the cafe's cellar. These letters detailed the society's plans and their efforts to protect the old quarter. They also hinted at a betrayal from within, which ultimately led to the society's downfall and the loss of the heart of the quarter. This discovery shed new light on the society's end and added a sense of urgency to Ethan's quest. He realized that the artifact was more than just a historical relic. It was a symbol of the old quarter's identity and heritage. Ethan's days and nights blurred together as he continued his search. He scoured every corner of the old quarter, following the clues left by the society. The journey was arduous, leading him through forgotten alleys, under the city's ancient arches, and into the depths of abandoned buildings. As chapter draws to a close, Ethan stands at the threshold of a significant discovery. He has deciphered the final clue, which points to the location of the heart of the quarter. The artifact is hidden somewhere in the city, waiting to be found. But Ethan is not alone in his quest. The mysterious figure is closing in, and the race to uncover the old quarter's greatest secret is reaching its climax. Chapter 4. The Confrontation and Revelation. The final clue in Ethan's hand trembled slightly as the realization of its implications dawned on him. The heart of the quarter, the artifact that held centuries of the city's secrets and the key to preserving its historical essence, was hidden within the very foundations of the old quarter, beneath the ancient mosque that had stood as a silent guardian over the city's transformations. As Ethan navigated the narrow streets towards the mosque, the sense of history enveloping the old quarter seemed more palpable than ever. The streets whispered of past lives and secrets, each cobblestone a testament to the city's enduring spirit. Upon reaching the mosque, Ethan found himself hesitating. The significance of what lay ahead weighed heavily on him. He was about to uncover a secret that had been sought after for generations, a secret that had the power to change the future of the old quarter. He was not alone in his quest. The mysterious figure that had been shadowing him, now revealed as a descendant of one of the society's members, confronted Ethan. This figure, a woman named Miriam, claimed that the artifact rightfully belonged to her family, who had been wronged by the society in the past. Their confrontation was tense, with Ethan trying to reason with Miriam about the importance of preserving the artifact for the good of the entire quarter, not just one family. However, Miriam was driven by a sense of ancestral duty and the desire for retribution. As they debated, it became clear that they shared a common goal, to protect the legacy of the old quarter. Their disagreement lay in the method of achieving it. Ethan believed in the collective memory and heritage of the quarter, while Miriam sought to right a historical wrong. The standoff was interrupted by the arrival of city officials, alerted to the presence of the artifact and its potential value. Suddenly, Ethan and Miriam found themselves united against a common threat, the commercialization and exploitation of the quarter's heritage. Working together, they managed to evade the officials and made their way to the hidden chamber beneath the mosque, where the heart of the quarter was said to be located. The chamber, a relic of a bygone era, was a maze of ancient carvings and relics. After navigating the complexities of the chamber, Ethan and Miriam found the heart of the quarter. The artifact was not a gemstone or a treasure trove of gold, but an ancient manuscript that detailed the history of the old quarter, its significance, and the wisdom of the generations that had lived there. The manuscript was a testament to the collective spirit of the old quarter, a call to preserve its identity against the tides of time and progress. It was a reminder that the true value of the quarter lay in its stories, its people, and its enduring spirit. Ethan and Miriam emerged from the mosque with a renewed sense of purpose. They understood that their fight was not over. The real challenge lay in protecting the essence of the old quarter in a rapidly changing world. As the story draws to a close, Ethan returns to whispers of the past, where Mr. Elazer and the cafe's patrons await. With the heart of the quarter in safe hands, the cafe becomes a beacon of hope and a center for the preservation of the quarter's heritage. Ethan's journey transforms him. What started as a search for a hidden artifact became a quest to safeguard the soul of the city. He realizes that his journey was not just about uncovering the past, but about shaping the future. The story ends with Ethan looking out over the old quarter, its rooftops bathed in the golden light of dawn. He sees not just a collection of buildings and streets, but a tapestry of lives and stories, a legacy that he is now a part of. The old quarter, with its mysteries and whispers of the past, continues to live on, a testament to the enduring spirit of the city.